Both the Leafs' playoff march and the Oilers' fall for Taylor Hall continues tonight as the Toronto Maple Leafs beat the Edmonton Oilers 6-4, leaving the Ice Crew one heck of an oil spill to clean up. Pat Quinn was welcomed back Saturday night with a video tribute to one of the Leafs' greatest coaches of all time, Pat Quinn. I mean, 80 playoff wins for the Leafs with him as the coach. I mean, how can you not say that he wasn't one of the greatest Leaf coaches of all time after that record? But I know that the Leafs have made tribute videos before on games and lost, especially with the Sundin return, the Darcy Tucker return, but not with the Pat Quinn return, as the Leafs open up the scoring in the first period, 6 minutes before the first period ends, with Kuhlman scoring, making it 1-0 Leafs. And then after that, Tyler Bolzac scores to make it 2-0 Leafs. And going into the second period, less than a minute after the period started, Cogliano scores to make it 2-1 for the Oilers. But then, John Mitchell scores to make it 3-1 for the Leafs, or so I thought that John Mitchell scored, but it turns out that Jamie Lundmark is getting credited for this goal, making it his 5th goal of the season, and his first as a Leaf. And then, all heck broke loose, fights galore, and penalties galore, as the Leafs had a 5-on-3, and this time they actually took advantage of that, with Phil Kessel scoring to make it 4-1 for the Leafs, and then Grabowski, on the same power play, scores to make it 5-1 for the Leafs. And that's when the whole frenzy starts, as Wayne Primo was pushed into the net, knocking Deloyer over by 2 Edmonton Oilers players. Now, this caused a scrimmage between about a dozen Leaf and Oilers players, including Deloyer going after Dion Phaneuf himself. I mean, I haven't seen a goalie do that at the Air Canada Center yet, but so this is probably going to be a new experience for Leafs fans who did go to the game tonight. And Dion Phaneuf, wow, it was great to see him in a fight with the Oilers, because that just brings back the, I think, rivalry between him and the Oilers team, giving the Leaf fans a taste of what the rivalry was like between the Oilers and the Flames. And so it was 5-1 Leafs, and Burley scores in the second period to make it 5-2 Leafs. And in the third period, Dustin Penner, you know, the guy who whose contract caused the big hatred between Burke and the Oilers general manager Kevin Lowe, and I think Steve Tambellini too. He scores on the Leafs to make it 5-3 for the Oilers. And then, funny thing is, the score was 5-3, and yet the Leafs were on a 5-on-3. And Phil Kessel scores in that 5-on-3 to make it 6-3 to the Leafs. But the Oilers were not done there. Their new acquisition from the Flames, Aaron Johnson, scores to make it 6-4. For the Leafs, and that's all she wrote for the Edmonton Oilers season this year, as the Toronto Maple Leafs have done something that they have not done since the 06-07 season, and that's eliminate a team from the playoffs. I mean, in the 06-07 season, it was Montreal. This time, it was the Edmonton Oilers. And I still believe that the Leafs will make the playoffs this time, especially since Boston lost, giving the Leafs some ground on 8th spot. And don't ask me what team they lost to, because just saying the name gives me a sour taste in my mouth. Ugh. Anyhow, The Leafs playoff march continues. The Oilers' fall for Taylor Hall continues. So Leaf fans and Oilers fans, I think, are going to be going home happy Saturday night with this win. And wow. And Sunday, the Leafs have the Islanders at 5 o'clock, a rare 5 o'clock start, on Leafs TV. So we can actually catch up to the Islanders with this Sunday win. So, until after Sunday, go Leafs, go!